Perfume. changes of season or place would make any change in my mind. While blessed with the sense of its love, a palace, a toy would appear, and prisons would palaces prove, if Jesus would dwell with me there.
Never. And that which we're looking forward to this is that which anchors our soul. The billows may toss us about. Trials will come. Our struggle with sin. But Christ paid for our sin, and he's returning. Because of those two simple facts, it is what?
It is what?
With our soul.
Amen.
Yeah. Another one. Paul, please.
Brother Matt Johnson, would you lead for us?
Amen.
I think Brother David had it.
Oh, what was your number, brother?
164.
Pardon me. 164. Number 164.
And then 582.
And then 582. 164.
Number 164.
The Church of Christ we have today, a blessing from the Lord. He gave her to his Son to save and take her home above. The Church will come. That I may share. Tell them all about our troubles. Hear our pain. may rise and hide the starry sky, but just a little talk with Jesus clears the way. Have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about our troubles. Hear our faintest cry. Answer by and by. Feel a little prayerful yearning. Heart and heaven is turning. Find a little talk with Jesus. Makes it right. I may have doubts and fear. My eyes be filled with tears. But Jesus is a friend who watches day and night. I go to him in prayer. He knows my every care. And just a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about our troubles. Hear our faintest cry. Answer by and by. Feel a little prayer. Three.
He's not. He had a rough night because you don't sleep in the hospital. And so he didn't get much rest, really. And so she was hopeful that getting a little extra pain medication at this time, he'd get to go to sleep. And so she said, maybe tomorrow. So we'll try again tomorrow. Let us please remember to hold him up in much prayer. I know there's many upon our hearts right now, most urgently, him coming freshly on the other side of the surgery. Please just hold him up in much prayer that the Lord would be round about him and bless him with a swift recovery. It's going to be a long 3 months for him and for Sister Susan. So let us please hold him up in much prayer. I also just want to mention this afternoon before we sing a hymn and conclude our singing here this afternoon. Brother Darren is really upon my mind this afternoon. He's in Hawaii, and so you might think, well, why would I feel sorry for him for that? And I'm not asking you to necessarily feel sorry for him, but I want you to pray for him. He got this new job, and it's good, and he likes it. He's being away from home a lot, and that's not what he wanted, and it's not what his family wants. Please, just pray for him, please, that the Lord would be round about him, bless him in this job, and bless the circumstance so that he can be in this job and making a living and being at home with his family. So we ask you just to please hold him up in prayer. Let's sing number 176, and it's been so good to have these hymns come forward and hopefully be able to record them and have just to go home with Brother Tim and Sister Laura as they head back to the Philippines. They can hear our voices from time to time and just know how much we love you and how much we love the Lord. And we actually got to sing a song that you selected, and I'm thankful for that. It's a beautiful song. Here. 176.
How did my heart rejoice to
175.
Blessed be the your loving care will surround them,
And Lord, that your sweet comfort will embrace them in your arms. We ask now, dear Heavenly Father, for peace and blessings upon all those who have gathered together here today. Lord, as we depart, that you would follow us and go with us closely to our respective homes. Lord, that as we gather together in our home churches tomorrow, that you would be that we have gathered together to worship and to glorify thy name. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.